Stephen, a 4-1 defeat at Oakleview Park today against Kiltie Parts. Can you give us your overall reaction to the game?
Yeah, obviously really disappointing, as you can imagine. Losing 4-1 at home, it's not a good feeling, but you know, goals change game. I thought we actually started really well, believe it or not, and you know, we were actually up for our own corner and it gets played to Daz and he actually holds it in and we're claiming for a penalty, and while we're claiming they hit us on the break, and to be honest, they were devastating at that today with Joe Cardo and Higginbottom and Alfredo Ajuman. Just the pace they had. But we've got to do better. You know, we spoke about, it wasn't as if we didn't know that. We spoke about all week about the players saying, look how dangerous they are when we are attacking, how their transition is lethal. Especially with the players have got, and they've not only got the pace to do it, it's the decision making and the quality these players have got. But three goals were identical. Two were from our own corners, and another one was from our own attack where they broke on us. So it's really disappointing, you know. And we've been saying to them there, you know, we've been saying for weeks, oh, it's going to click. But you can't get beat 4-1 at home, and that's going to, I'm the manager, so that falls on me. And there's got to be, you know, we've obviously gave players a lot of time, but we need to make a few changes, I think. Just to give other players that are being patient in the wings, to go and give them an opportunity, because it's not happening for us. And you know, I still believe we've definitely got the squad in there to change, but that is a real sore one today, and we need to regroup. We'll take a break for the league. We go into Cove next week, but that is it's a sore one to take. We're all hurting at the moment.
And we did have quite a few chances to, obviously it was 2-1, and we had quite a few chances to bring the game level, because I thought for 10 minutes before their third goal, I thought it was just all Stennis Field basically. Ross Forbes has a free kick, excellently saved by Darren Jameson, and goals, we get a corner, and they go and score. Do you think we could obviously dealt with the goal better?
Oh, absolutely. I mean, like I said, it was the same again. It was a breakaway through our corner, but the third goal, and that actually just takes a life out the whole game. So that, of course, what you said there, you're so disappointed with the goal, but also what you said was, you know, we were great middle to front, actually creating chances, and with the goal disallowed, and creating chances wasn't the problem today. You know, it was dealing with the breakaway and the transition and the pace of Kelty, and we didn't deal with it. And like I say, you feel as if you set the team up to deal with that, but I've got to take that in the chin, you know. I'm the manager, and the buck stops at me, so I've got to look at it, and maybe we need to add a bit more pace in the transition to defend better. So we need to look at that. We've got a big enough squad, even though we had four missing with COVID. Everybody's in the same boat just now, but what we do feel at this moment in time is really disappointing.
And at 1-0 down, I thought we were still in the game, and obviously we're going to score through Adam Brown. I think it's a fantastically taken goal, but it just shows you that we're not relying on our strikers. It's another week where it's not a striker that scored.
Yeah, I mean, well, you say strikers. I mean, Tomo was up there as the focal point, but we do look to have like three attacking players round about him, and Ewan, Adam and Daz. And Darren was kind of toiling right for the start with a wee injury. He picked up, tried to get him through much of the game as we could, but he was really struggling, so we kind of lost that threat, which was a big part of our game plan. But we changed as we try and get Thomas Oro on as well. So the strikers didn't score, but I thought we had a lot of chances with attacking threat we did have on the pitch. So we'll just need to roll on and try and dust ourselves down again. We've got Cove next week, as I say, and that game against Annan, women in the league after that, you know, that's going to be huge.
And you said we had four players out due to COVID. Without going into, I know you won't want to go too much about it, but have you got an indication who's going to be coming back for next week's game?
I think, we've still got the isolation period. We've got Sean, we've got Jordan Tappen, we've got John Craig, James Lyons out, we've still got Graham Smith out, you know. But plus, you know, I keep saying it, we've brought this squad in. I still believe in the squad. We've got great strength and depth. So we just need to work hard and try and get it to turn, which I'm sure it will. But today was a real bitter blow, and maybe we're feeling like this. And you know, I'm certainly right at this moment in time hurting. And for the fans, again, they turned out in numbers. I really feel for them. I apologise to them for the actual scoreline. But like you say, there was things we can take out. We were decent middle to front building, but transition today wasn't good enough. So we need to look at that and dust ourselves down, as I say.
Stephen, thanks for your time. On to next week.
Worries.